Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Can you help me say it? I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Oh, the Holy Ghost told me everything's gonna be all right. Oh, the Holy Ghost told me everything's gonna be all right. Oh, the Holy Ghost told me everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Oh, got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Send to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercies endure forever. For I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Somebody said, I came running when they said unto me, let's go into the house of the Lord. It wasn't nobody running after me. I was just glad to get back to the house of the Lord. We praise God for you on this morning, for this is the day that the Lord has made. We are rejoicing and being glad. And seeing that the Lord has caused us to see another sun rise, another day that we have not seen before, another, amen, blessings that he has bestowed on our lives. I thank God that he is in charge of my life. I continue to look to the hills from which cometh my help, knowing that all of my help comes from the Lord, which made both the heavens and the earth. God bless you again on this great Sunday morning. You got your Bibles. You got your Bibles. Put your Bibles out. Turn to the book of Hosea, the 11th chapter. We're going to begin at the first verse in verses 1. They have 1, 2, 7, 8, 9, and 10. But just Hosea 11 chapter, verses 1 through 10. I won't be reading all of those, but I'll be reading through them, verses 1 through 10. And Hosea, the 12th chapter, verses 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 14. So on both of these, amen, Hosea 11, 1 through 14, and Hosea 12, 1 through 14. So as you have your Bibles, take your Bibles out. Let's begin to read, open unto the word of the Lord. Let's see what God is going to say to us on this morning. 11 and 1, it reads, when Israel was a child, then I loved him and called my son out of Egypt. As they called them, so they went from them. They sacrificed unto Balaam, burned incense to graven images, and my people are bent to backsliding from me. Though they called them to the Most High, none at all would exalt him. How shall I give thee up, Ephraim? How shall I deliver thee? I'm at verse 8, I'm sorry. Israel, how shall I make thee as Admon and set thee as Zeboam? My heart is turned within me. My repentance are kindled together. Verse 9, I will not execute the fierceness of my anger. I will not return to destroy Ephraim, for I am God and not man, the Holy One in the midst of thee, and I will not enter into the city. They shall walk after the Lord. He shall roar like a lion. When he shall roar, then the children shall tremble from the west. Let us go to Hosea, the 12th chapter. We're going to begin at the first verse. And it says, Ephraim feeded on wind and fallen after the east wind. He daily increased lies and desolation. And they do make a covenant with the Assyrians, and all is carried unto Egypt. Verse 2. The Lord also have a controversy with Judah, and will punish Jacob according to his ways. According to his doings will he recompense him. Verse 6. Therefore, turn thou to thy God, keep mercy and judgment, and wait on thy God continually. Verse 7. He is a merchant. The balances of deceit are in his hand, and he loveth to oppress. Verse 8. And Ephraim said, yea, I am become rich. I have found me out of substance. All in all my labors, they shall find more iniquity in me that they were sin. And I that am the Lord thy God from the land of Egypt will make thee to dwell in tabernacles as in the days of the solemn feast. Verse 10. I have also spoken by the prophets. I have multiplied visions and used similitudes by the ministry of the prophets. Is there iniquity in Gilead? Surely they are vanity. They sacrifice bullocks in Gilgad. Yea, there are altars as heaps in the furrows of the fields. Verse 12. And Jacob fled into the country of Syria. Israel served for a wife, and for a wife he kept sheep. 13. And by a prophet the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. By a prophet was he preserved. Ephraim provoked him to anger most bitterly. Therefore shall he leave his blood upon him, and his report shall the Lord return unto him. What a powerful lesson on this morning as we begin to talk about return to love and justice. Return to love and justice. The Bible said return. It said return to love and justice. As we begin to go through these scriptures on this morning, we're going to begin to understand that how much God cares about his people. Regardless of what people say, regardless what the enemy say, regardless what the devil is trying to tell you about God, God is concerned about his people. And as we begin to read this lesson and go through this study on today, as we've seen from previous lessons in Sunday school, that it's continually that the people whom God loved continue to sin, wherein they put their own selves into captivity. You ought to tell somebody, say, have you put yourself into captivity because you have disobeyed God? No one talks about the sin that we do. Nobody talks about the captivity that we're in is because we've caused this and we brought this upon our own selves. Every time evil is to come, every time destruction is to come, every time trials and tribulation comes, everybody always wants to blame God. Why is God allowing this? Why is God allowing that? Why don't God do something? But have anybody looked at the sin of mankind? Have anybody talked about the sin of mankind? Anybody talking about the evil that mankind is doing? No, nobody's going to talk about the evil that man is doing from high to low, from the president to the nobody. Nobody's talking about the evil that they're doing, but every time there's destruction somewhere, where is God? Every time there's evil somewhere, where is God? Every time something goes wrong, where is God? Well, God is in the same place that he has been all the time. He's on his throne. He's sitting high and he's looking low and he's watching men sin and he's watching men imprison his own self by his own actions, by his own ways, and by his own evil doing. There's just a lot of things that God is not going to recover us from because our sins is bringing the evil on our own self. If you want to get rid of the diseases and the evils that's going on in the world, we got to get rid of the sin that's causing it. That's right. Nobody is talking about the sin. Nobody's talking about the errors. Nobody is talking about the wrong. But we're talking about the outcome of the consequences of what has been done. But what God is saying to Israel on this morning, again, your sins have caused you to go into captivity. And even though, Israel, you keep this obeying me, God shall yet love you. All right. Oh my, what a God we serve. As wrong as you are, as wrong as you do, as you continue in your error, God said, I won't leave you. I won't leave you desolate. I won't forsake you. But now I am going to allow you. I am going to allow you to get some consequences of your sins that you are doing. Yes, as the word have said, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man what soweth, that shall he also reap. Watch this now before we get into the lesson. You got to understand something. You can't go out and sow a bad field and think you're going to reap a good harvest. God is saying to you, you've done some things in your life. You're doing some things in your life that's causing harm and danger your way. And you can't expect God to eradicate those things that you're constantly planting on yourself. So God said, oh yeah, you're going to go through that storm. You're going to go through that trial. You're going to walk through that field because you planted, because whatsoever you sow, you are going to reap. So I tell you what, let's get ahead of it. From the day on, be careful what you sow. Amen in the house. Be careful what you sow. Be careful what you say. Be careful what you do. Be careful where you go. Because it is, the old folks would say, it is going to come up again. Sooner or later, it's going to come up again. So be careful as we go through this life. Now, as we venture into this lesson on this morning, again, thank God for the prophet, the man of God, Hosea. They called him a minor prophet. And when I told you before about minors and majors, it simply meant that the minor prophets, where there was not a lot of detail, or a lot of written, or a lot of recordings of these particular prophets. So that's why they called them minor. Not minor as they were not important, not minor or as they were less than, just simply minor as in less writings, less recordings. The major prophets were those who did a lot of writing, so they call that major. So we don't get confused about who's greater. No one of them was greater than the other. One just was giving more information and the other wasn't. Well, on this morning in the book of Hosea, as we begin to go through this lesson in the morning, the people of Israel had continued to be unfaithful to God, watch this, through their worship. Through their worship. That's why Hebrews said, forsake not the assembly of yourselves together as the manner of some is. But when we come together in worship, when we come back together again in worship, the purpose of coming together and assembling together is that we may worship God and not man, that we may give God the glory and not man, that we may talk about God and not man, that we may talk about God and not you and not your family, not your friends, not your neighbors, but talk about God. So God said Israel had become unfaithful again in their worship to me. I mind you, many of you that had the opportunity to be in the house of the Lord, you came to church, you sat on the pew, you folded your arms, you crossed your hands and you crossed your legs, and you sit there as the songs was being sang, you sit there as people was worshiping God, you sit there as the preacher was preaching, you sit there as they prayed for others, just like nothing was happening. They were coming, but they were not giving God the proper worship that God was asking for. And maybe when you get the opportunity again, you're going to act like you know God. You're going to act like you love God. You're going to lift up your hands. You're going to open up your mouth. You're going to stand on your feet. You're going to give God some praise and worship. So they had become faithful to God through their worship. And they sought out, watch this, relationships with Assyria and Egypt. I'm going to share something with you on this morning, and we got to begin to understand. Listen, let us not go back to that which God has brought us from. Let us not go back and entangle ourselves again with things that God has brought us out of. In Assyria and Egypt were the heathen nations. They were the heathen people. And God had already told Israel, I don't want you to have no relations with the heathen. Don't let your sons and your daughters marry their sons and their daughters. What God was trying to tell Israel is, listen, they don't believe me like you're supposed to believe me. So no sense in your entangling yourself or involving yourself or wrapping yourself up with those that don't believe like you believe. Trust the God that you trust. Love the God that you love. So he said, listen, why would you go and do this just for military gain? Again, it was not for the purpose that they may get closer to God. It was for the purpose of them trying to get some military, let's just say, some tangible things on earth. And let me ask you a question. What are you entangling yourself in that's corrupt and that's not right? That you're trying to get some gain illegally? Hello in the house. Some gain illegally. But God was continuing to tell Israel, I love you. God was frustrated, yes, with Israel. He was frustrated with what they were giving him. God was pretty much angry about their decision.